So you promise to do the washing up and tidy your room, yes?
Yes. One day.
What are you expecting to find, anyway?
I don't know, a Miley Cyrus karaoke DVD, Peter Andre's latest life story, box of human noses. A curious situation for our heroes to find themselves in, I think you'll agree. This was how we're going to start the episode, but we decided it was too confusing. In fact, we changed our minds.
So that's why the cat went to the moon. And finally, the TV show Flannel Alan has been cancelled. The stupid programme about a stupid flannel called Alan has been called rubbish and stupid by everyone, except the Prime Minister, who used a swear word. We spoke to the man who finally axed the stupid flannel, BBC boss Todd Otterback.
It was the only TV show you could hear people's mums complaining about from space. This is the most popular decision I've made since giving Barney Harwood his own TV channel. Oh, no.
Oh, dear.
Shall we go to the other end of the bath, Flannel Alan? Shall we? What's that you say, Flannel Alan? No, still not getting it.
Little Howard, can I come in?
Can Big Howard come in, Flannel Alan? No, I've no idea what you're saying.
Little Howard, I'm afraid I've got some bad news.
Oh, no. Has the goldfish died? Again?
No. Boss of the BBC's cancelled Flannel Alan.
What? Who? How? Why?
Well, apparently, everyone thinks it's rubbish.
Oh, and everyone's opinion is more important than mine, is it? It's my favourite.
No. Look, Flannel Alan wouldn't want us to be sad, would he? He'd carry on galloping about with his merry squawk. He wouldn't go to...
Hi, little Howard, I've come up with another one of my big questions. How can I change someone's mind?
I do wish you wouldn't do that. Now, stop.
My two fishy wooden poo hat. You love monkeys, you love monkeys, all those happy little chirpy little monkeys with their tails and their bananas. You think that if we all were monkeys, you'd have happier mananas. Give you monkeys, lots of monkeys, for you know that it's the monkeys you adore. If your love said that you did not love those monkeys, you wouldn't love her anymore, would you?
There. My hypno-specs have convinced our entire audience that they love monkeys. Quick, lads, form a boy band.
I love monkeys.
Mother, how do I change someone's mind about something?
What's that banging?
It's Big Howard trying to get out of my wardrobe. I need to change the boss of the BBC's mind about...
Who? Todd Otterback? He's dishy.
He's not. He's just cancelled Flannel Alan.
Well, you could try to argue with him.
What? Like call him a big flathead and kick him in the
dick?
No, that's fighting. Arguing's different. Argument is the use of words to convince people using logic and reason. You need to persuade him that he's got it wrong.
But how do I find him?
Well, I have hacked into the BBC mainframe and downloaded his mobile number and diary.
Wow. You did all that for me?
Nope. I did that ages ago. Did I mention he's a hottie?
Yes. Thanks. Where are you going? I'm going to find the boss of the BBC and kick him in the knee. What?
Little Howard, you can't argue with Todd Otterback. He's the most unreasonable boss the BBC's ever had.
If you annoy him, he might cancel our show.
Shut. According to his diary, he's...
Where'd you get his diary?
Spending time with his friend, Jim.
I can't get enough. This is taking me now.
makes Todd Otterback the most feared man in telly.
He's just a big pussycat. And a hottie, apparently.
Janet, I want it with mayonnaise or I'm cancelling Antigs Roadshow.
Right away.
Todd Otterback, I put it to you very convincingly that Flannel Alan is good and not vomit.
What? Flannel Alan is like watching paint dry.
Watching paint dry?
Yes, watching paint dry was a show we did on BBC Four for a while. I cancelled it. It was nearly as rubbish as Flannel Alan.
How dare you!
One day, I will be powerful enough to actually cancel people.
Hello, Todd Otterback!
I can't talk now. I'm on a rowing mission.
I just called to say, got a dishy hottie!
What? I'm a dishy hottie? Who is this?
In a recent survey, 100% of cartoon boys said that Flannel Alan is the best show on telly ever.
Yeah, that's just you, isn't it?
God, this arguing lot's hard, isn't it?
Sorry, Mr. Otterback, sir. I'm sorry.
I put it to you.
Aren't you in one of my TV shows?
Yes.
Yes, he's Richard Hammond off Top Gear. Nice thighs, by the way.
Blimey, he's grown. Janet, cancel Top Gear.
Yes, Mr. Otterback.
Now.
Right away, sir.
Let go! He nearly agreed with me then!
No, he didn't. He's a very powerful man and he hates Flannel Alan. There's no point, it's a lost cause.
That is a shame.
Please don't cry, please. Stop the...
It's my favourite programme in the world, Big Owl!
There's nothing we can do.
I'll just be incredibly sad for the rest of my life.
I mean, if there was anything we could do, I'd...
Don't worry, Big Owl. I'll just cry until all my ink dissolves in tears.
All right, I'll help!
Brilliant. Right, I thought we could change the minds of the entire country with a colossal advertising campaign.
So, a nationwide advertising campaign on television, radio, magazines, the internet, billboards and football sponsorship will come to about, carry the three, £40 million.
How much is an advert in the newsagent's window?
50p.
Little Howard, you haven't got £40 million in your piggy bank. I don't think you've even got 50p.
Okay, plan B, blackmail.
What?
Sorry, not blackmail. What's the word when you find out an embarrassing secret about someone and then threaten to tell everyone if they don't do what you say?
That is blackmail.
Call it what you like, Big Howard. All we have to do is sneak into Todd Otterback's house and...
Can I come?
No, and find evidence of something that could ruin his career.
No way! Blackmail is illegal and immoral, and under no circumstances am I going to go out there and sit in a garden.
So you promise to do the washing up and tidy your room, yes?
Yes. One day.
What are you expecting to find anyway?
I don't know. Miley Cyrus karaoke DVD, Peter Andre's latest life story, box of human noses.
You know if he catches us, that's our career's over. We'll have to go and live in a skip. Mother will have to go and live on eBay.
Oh, here he comes.
Now, I don't care what Jeremy Clarkson says. The tiny cartoon one annoyed me at the gym, so Top Gear is finished. You hear?
So we just wait here and wait till he goes to bed. Little Howard?
Of course Richard Hammond is a cartoon. I've just met him.
Little Howard!
Now, if I was collecting the paws of neighbourhood cats, where would I hide them?
Stop over there, Mike.
Cancel that. News. Cancel it.
What the?
Little Howard's for it now. This show could be cancelled, and he could even go to jail for attempted blackmail and trespassing. I can't watch. In fact, I'm watching the ads with my eyes closed.
This is TV's much loved Flannel. Flannel Alan, in happier times. But now this small, defenceless face cloth is being forced off our screens and onto the streets. Giving just £40 million will help us buy a national advertising campaign to change the mind of everyone in the country and get him back on telly, where he belongs.
You broke my beautiful play collection! I can see that cancelling Top Gear didn't get the message through your tiny mallet! I'm gonna make sure that you never, ever... Richard? Richard Hamster Hammond? Ooh. I don't remember ordering a life-size cutout of Richard Hammond. Must be a promotional thing. Creepy.
What happened then?
I guess that cliffhanger was so dramatic I got stuck in the freeze frame.
Oh, that's plausibly useful.
Let's get out of here.
Well, one of us is. Little Howard snuck into Todd Otterback's house to try and find something to blackmail him with so he wouldn't cancel Flannel Alan.
Did you find anything?
That is hardly the point. It's dangerous, it's illegal. Did you?
Perhaps a hanky that smells of his aftershave?
No. He just sits in an armchair watching telly and reading magazines all day. And he collects rubbishy ceramic plates. Well, collected.
That's it. I'm having nothing more to do with your big question.
Oh, well, I didn't want to do this, but...
Please, McHale, please,
Oh, thank goodness. I reckon three more pleases and I would have probably given up.
You might not have made it past two.
Sorry, Mother. Where were we? I just had to change Big Howard's mind again.
I've been thinking about Todd Otterback.
Yes? Have you got a plan?
No. I've just been thinking about his lovely face. Oh! Did you say he loves telly and magazines? That gives me an idea.
David Tennant gets Flannel Alan tattoo. I wish I had a flannel like Alan, says David Beckham. Hey, oh, that infernal flannel must be more popular than I realised. Ooh, he's got his own range of ceramic plates.
I've hacked it to his satellite dish. I'm just broadcasting the propaganda to his TV now.
This just in. Thousands of people are taking to the streets to protest against the cruel cancellation of Flannel Alan.
My goodness. Well, I've completely misjudged the mood of the nation. I better buy those plates.
Hello, Flannel Alan ceramic plates.
Yeah.
Ian Sterling.
Is that you?
No, sir, it's Chris. Chris Johnson, sir.
All the CBBC celebs run
Flannel Alan ceramic companies in our spare time. It's because we love him so much.
Really? I'll have 20, please.
Nice work, Chris.
Thank you. Now, please, can you not draw glasses and a moustache on Hacker?
Get off me, little Alan!
Jamie, I need a word about...
Yes, Mr. Otterback, sir?
Flannel Alan.
Coming soon, the all-new adventures of Flannel Alan. But good.
Little Alan, wake up! We've done it! We've changed his mind! Flannel Alan's back!
The dino flyers and robo-gators are closing in. Flannel Alan trans-flannel forms into Flannel Manta Ray.
That's not Flannel Alan.
I know. It looks really good.
It's not his voice. And his bath doesn't fly in space. That's stupid.
Hello?
Hi. Are you Richard Hammond's dad? Tell him I've put Flannel Alan back on TV.
I know. We saw it. It looks amazing.
No. It looks different.
We pumped loads of money in to make it less rubbish. And to pay for it, we had to cancel a little show called, Little Howard's Big Question or something. But don't worry. I uncancelled Top Gear.
Hooray! Big Howard, this new Flannel Alan looks rubbish. It's got none of the original's homespun charm.
Oh, that's a shame, because they've cancelled our show to pay for it!
Talk about adding insects to surgery.
What are we gonna... The phrases add insult to injury. What are we gonna do?
Well, we just have to change his mind back. Again. About two things.
What?
Obama is said to be profoundly disgusted by the cynical relaunch of Flannel Alan. He says it's a massive blow to world peace.
Celebrities are so fickle. I'm sticking with a very expensive new flannel.
Still coming soon to BBC One. This Saturday night, the all-new adventures of Flannel...
We failed. Our TV show is over.
There is one more idea that might work.
No, there isn't. We changed his mind too well the first time.
But...
No, you've bribed me, pestered me, and emotionally blackmailed me to help you, but I've had enough. It's pointless.
I hate you! You're always doing this! You don't care about me at all, do you?
Do you really think that having a tantrum's going to make me change my mind? Because it isn't. I'm not going to end up dressed as a ninja hiding behind a tree in the next shot. No way!
What's the plan this time?
We sneak into his house while he's asleep and hypnotise him into changing his mind back.
What?
What? Dave, come on.
I hate you! You're so unkind to me!
Might work.
Have you ever actually hypnotised anyone before?
No, but how hard could it be? You are feeling very sleepy.
Of course he is, he's asleep.
You're feeling very asleep.
Richard Hammond and some bloke.
Our monkey does.
What are we going to do?
Two, three, four. Please don't do it.
you know that it is wrong. The only thing we haven't tried is telling you a song. Please don't do it, I'm not thinking of me. I'm thinking of the children and I'm down on bended knee. Please don't do it, it isn't very kind. And we'll do nearly anything to make you change your mind. Please don't do it, look at his little face. Do you really want to go and put a flannel in his place?
Yes, I do.
Please don't do it, that flannel's not as good. You shouldn't recommission it, what made you think you should? Please don't do it, my question went too far. And if you choose our programme, he will buy you a new car.
What?
A Skoda?
No.
A Lada?
No.
A Mini? A trike? A red Passat estate in any colour that you like? A Fiat? A Mazda? A Peugeot?
No.
A Ford?
I've got
one. If you increase the budget, there's a Porsche we might afford.
What?
One of each, and you're on.
Yes, we've done it! OK, it wasn't free. It only took a little bit of auto-bribery. Yes, we've done it. He's gone and changed his mind. It's just we still have quite a lot of money left to find.
So it all worked out fine. Flannel Alan and Little Howard's Big Question are both still on TV.
Yeah, and all I have to do is buy Todd Otterback 9 cars and a tricycle.
He's worth it.
How are you going to pay for it?
Why, with the Little Howard's Big Question ceramic play collection.
I'll tell you what, I'll smash open my piggy bank with a hammer.
Don't think there'll be that much money in it, Little Howard.
Oh, no. I just want to smash open my piggy bank with a hammer.